WWE made several on-the-fly changes to last week's SmackDown. Elsewhere, an ex-champion in WWE has made their in-ring comeback, and an injured Raw superstar could be close to returning. More on that in the wrestling news. Hello everybody, we are back again with more wrestling news. Check out the earlier video on the channel already if you want. But now we're going to be talking about SmackDown last week because Fightful Select have revealed that it was all.
Which is surprising news, because I've not seen the show yet myself. It's on my list of things to do today, but 48 minutes or so on Twitter, the Bloodline stuff took up the entire show.
Wow.
Of 2 hours, so.
That feels like it was pre-planned.
Exactly, yes. But Fightful Select are saying there were some significant time issues on SmackDown as the Bloodline segment went over on time.
That would make
several
sense.
Matches and entrances had to be adjusted on the fly. LA Knight not being on the show. He was not on the show. Why do they do this? Oh, we put smiles on people's faces. Oh, we have the most popular guy in the world over here, but we'll not have him win the big one and then not have him appear on SmackDown.
That was nothing to do, Fightful have confirmed, with the timing issues for SmackDown, as he was only ever planned for a dark segment the whole time. They had planned ahead of the show to release the segment on digital platforms. So yeah, he was never going to be part of the show, unfortunately. I don't know why.
Should be following this up with a challenge for Logan Paul. Get himself on that Ricochet feud.
Yes, he should.
Spice it up a bit.
But yeah, apart from that, the Bloodline stuff apparently went overtime, which, I mean, it's always bad news, I suppose, when things have to be changed because certain matches or segments run over. But if anything was going to, I think that's probably the one you can forgive the most.
Yeah.
Because it's the centerpiece of SmackDown.
Of the entire company, you would say.
Of the wrestling world.
And again, I guess it is harsh to say, but it is nice to see a SmackDown with more killer than filler. If that's a thing you can say about sort of thing, when the lads have clearly gone to business for themselves. Boo the lads.
Boo Roman and Solo, I suppose.
He never shuts up, that Solo, does he?
That's true. I bet it was his fault. Elsewhere, an ex-AEW star is opening a wrestling school. That's Fuego del Sol, whose contract expired last month. He recently asked online if people would be interested in attending a wrestling school run by him. The response was really positive, and as we speak, he is apparently getting a team together and putting a business plan in place to do just that.
He later tweeted, "Try to talk myself out of it, convince myself I wasn't qualified yet, but looking at the options in my state, I realized I have a ton of knowledge to pass on and how big of a help I could be with the proper curriculum and mentorship from successful trainers. Why not do it?
Why not do it, Fuego del Sol?" Bit of shade thrown at whoever else is the wrestling school in his state.
I was going to say, what state is he in?
I don't know. I hope it's not Texas, because Booker T is going to be... Well, I think it is Texas, though. Because isn't Fuego del Sol Sammy Guevara's mate?
Yeah.
And isn't he the Houston, Texas boy?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
It could be, yeah. Shucky ducky, quack, quack. He'll be at the front door flexing and everything.
We're not... It hasn't yet been confirmed whether Fuego del Sol's training school is in Texas. And even if it is, I wish him the... He sounds like he's got his head screwed on right there.
He seems like a nice fella.
He does seem like a nice man.
He won a car once.
He did win a car. Did he?
Then lost the car to Miro.
I was going to say Miro beat him, but he won the car previously.
I think so. Or latterly, I can't remember now.
Speaking of wrestling trainers, one such wrestling trainer who's one of the more high profile modern day wrestling trainers, I reckon, is Tyler Breeze, the former NXT Tag Team Champion. But he also made his in-ring return on Saturday night for Next Generation Wrestling.
Isn't that over here?
Tennessee.
NGW,
Next Generation Wrestling, Tennessee.
All right.
It's like CSI,
the
Miami.
Tennessee. Yeah. Do you reckon they're linked? No.
I think one's a feeder system for the other.
Tyler Breeze beat Matt Cross for the NGW TN Championship. They're all very close to things that happen like on a bigger scale, I guess. Is that a fair thing to say? TN Championship. This is the first time Breeze wrestled since he and Fandango faced Imperium on the June the 15th episode of NXT.
When they came to NXT?
I assume that was 2 years ago?
I can't even...
A year ago? It's either a year or 2 years.
Time's all messed up since the lockdown. Breeze was released, unfortunately, from WWE in 2021, but has since signed a non-wrestling deal with the company as part of the Up Up Down Down YouTube channel. It's a deal that stops him, though, from taking AEW commitments, but apparently doesn't stop him from working certain indie events, because he's also next in action for Prestige Wrestling on September the 1st in Portland, Oregon. He's always someone, I mean, I don't know the man or anything, I don't know what his plans looked like, but he was always someone who had felt like his career ended prematurely when he was released from WWE. I thought, hang on, he's still in great shape, he's still really good, he's still relatively, well, does he just look young?
Maybe he does look young.
Oh.
But it is weird when you look back at like 2015 Tyler Breeze when he was in NXT with his seasonal residences mm-hmm. and stuff like that. Then going on the main roster, he got that feud with Ziggler mm-hmm. and everything looked like it was going like that. And then it just stopped and he was just putting the tag team with Fandango, which in fairness to them, they made
the most.
They
yeah.
made work, didn't they? Yeah. But yeah, just it felt like a case of what might have been with Tyler Breeze.
You really did. Yeah. He was wrestling Jushin Thunder Liger on NXT and then yeah. It's a shame. Elsewhere, Stephen Amell, who's formerly been in WWE, but also has formerly been in... Well...
He's Cody Rhodes' friend.
Was he in AEW? Or was he at All In?
He appeared on All In.
It was All In AEW. Yeah. Well, spiritually.
Yeah.
The spirit of All In
died.
He's got
a foot in both camps, potentially.
He does. He's going to be... he's also the star, I should mention, of wrestling-based drama Heels on the Stars channel, or network, as they say in America, that's on Stars. And he said on Facebook that he's going to be on Monday Night Raw next week. They've not promoted him yet.
No, they haven't.
That's crazy.
It'll just be as big as pop as Brock Lesnar coming out there as a surprise. Yeah. Cody yeah. Rhodes will be like, I'm here to challenge Seth Rollins. Lesnar will come out, they'll have a fight. Amell will come out and make the save. Beat Brock Lesnar up.
Throw Brock Lesnar around. Yeah. No details have yet been shared as to what capacity he'll be in or how it ties into the launch of the next season of Heels Season 2, which is about to come out soon. If it even does tie in at all. He has previously wrestled for WWE, teaming with Neville or Pac in a feud with Cody Rhodes as Stardust. I remember him jumping off the top rope.
Yeah, who is that jumping out the sky?
Stephen Amell. It's a really nice normal name, isn't it?
Yeah.
For a Hollywood man.
But I think there was an update to this. It was not related production or something like that he's going to be there to do, or was it related to the company?
He's given an interview recently saying that he's going to be in WWE soon for something that he's working on concurrently with Heels. It was all a bit confusing. He said he would have promoted it with AEW if Cody was still there, because CM Punk's also a cast member on Heels.
Oh.
But instead, Cody's not there. Cody's in WWE.
Yeah,
so.
CM Punk wears some sort of hairy loincloth thing, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's like a weird, as far as I can tell, wildlife bit raccoon-based heel.
A raccoon-based heel.
Yeah, and he's a gross man.
Watch out for your bins, everybody. CM Punk's about.
I've not watched it, though. Have you watched it?
No, I've not seen
it. If it's any good, let us know. Give your reviews of Heels.
I don't know where we get it over here. Where do we get the Stars Network?
Get it, yeah. And finally, could an injured WWE star be close to a return, according to PW Insider?
It's an earth-shattering one, everybody, because this weekend, R-Truth was spotted in Birmingham, Alabama. I don't know what we'll do with this information. He was most likely to get checked out as part of the process for a potential in-ring return, because that's where you go. It always feels like when someone had a big knee injury or something like that, they go to Birmingham.
As English people, the only time we hear Birmingham, Alabama mentioned is when a wrestler needs surgery.
Yeah.
I didn't realise it was also somewhere you go if you... Maybe he's already had surgery, you're just getting
rehab.
The final check. Yeah, I didn't realise that was also the place, but apparently it's the place to be. Triple H went there when we were children. That's famous. It made the city famous in my mind.
He sat on a bench like that and went, ooh.
And U2 was playing in the back. Yeah. Was it U2?
Oh,
the video package, yeah.
Beautiful day, wasn't it?
Yeah. What a magical place it must be, Birmingham, Alabama.
I don't know, like, it seems quite desolate.
just the injured wrestlers
walking
around. Go
there for injured
around.
Knees, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know what we made of that, though, because R-Truth wasn't really doing much before he left. I don't know when he left, but he's ageless. He'll come back.
It feels weird to be talking about a period of R-Truth's extended absence, because he just seems so indestructible.
Yeah.
He doesn't, as you say, he doesn't age. Is he 50 yet?
Over.
My God.
Over.
What a magnificent man.
I'm confident in saying that.
Wow. Whether or not he is, he's definitely older than he seems by far. But hopefully he'll be back getting rowdy, and hopefully you're all getting rowdy on this fine Monday as well. Thanks very much for watching.
Yeah, yeah.
That bit of the song takes
rowdy.
You by surprise, doesn't it, when
that
starts?
Bloody hell, road dog.
Thanks very much for watching this news video. Check out our earlier news video, as I said earlier today, on this very channel, and leave your thoughts and opinions in the comments section down below. And we will see you soon.